Hello guys, welcome to my fourth class of inverse Laplace transform. In the previous three classes, we discussed based on inverse Laplace transform, how we get that value from the Laplace transform. Now, along with that, we are going to consider some more standard result. What we discussed in last three class is not sufficient to find out inverse transform. Therefore, we again will consider some more result, what you already know that in the Laplace transform. Now we know that we already discussed in Laplace transform class, Laplace transform of t into f of t is nothing but minus 1 into first derivative of f of s, where f of s is nothing but Laplace transform of f of t. Whenever they multiply t or t square, then we are going to use formula. Suppose your t square is to differentiate twice and then we get the power is 2, like that. Okay? Now from this, what is my inverse Laplace transform? What's the formula? T into f of t is nothing but L inverse of minus 1 into first derivative of f of s. This formula actually is very much useful. So we have to solve more number of problems based on this. The second one, this also we discussed in the Laplace transform. Laplace transform of f of t by t is nothing but s to infinity capital f of s ds. From this, what is my f of t by t? L inverse of s to infinity f of s ds with respect to s. Now, after once you evaluate this, just you take t as a cross multiplication, we get f of t. Now, this is a formula we are going to use whenever is keep in mind, whenever is possible to evaluate f of s in the limit s to infinity, then only we are going to use this formula. We can't use always. We can't able to evaluate in the between s to infinity for function f of s. In that case, we can't proceed. We don't get it f of t. Therefore, while applying the results, please take care. Whenever is possible, I to apply suitable formulas. The third one, this also we discussed in the Laplace transform. Laplace transform of 0 to t f of t dt is nothing but f of s by s. What is L inverse of f of s by s is 0 to t f of t dt. Now we are going to use this formula whenever having the denominator s. Now it's possible to bifurcate s from the numerator value. And also after f of s we get f of t is possible to evaluate. Then only we are going to use formula. Otherwise we are going for the first formula, because first formula just have to differentiate. Are you clear? While taking second and third, please take care we have to use second and third. If you want to go for second formula, you must be verified whether it's possible find out integral value of the given function of f of s in the limit s to infinity. Then only have to move for this formula. Otherwise, the next is whenever it's possible to bifurcate s in the denominator from the numerator, now I'll go for this. Along with that, after we get f of t is possible to evaluate in this range. But the first one, there is no whatever restriction. Now, we have to, suppose I have to take L of f of t is equal to f of t. Now, what is my f of t from this? F of t is nothing but what? L inverse of f of s. Okay? Anyway, they given already f of s. Just you have to differentiate. After the differentiation, some cases easily we get what's the inverse transform. Because after you once you differentiate, it is converted into one of the standard form. Therefore, usually we are going to give a preference to use the first result. Okay? I think everyone is clear. Now, even though it's not clear, while solving a problem, then there must be definitely have become a perfect for that. The first formula, you keep in mind in all the problem you are finding a inverse Laplace transform. The first function is 1 by s into s square plus a square. I want to find out Laplace transform of this. There are two methods to go for this. Is a fraction, is a proper fraction, apply partial fraction, convert some of the term and proceed. That's the one method you already know that in the last class. This can also be written as L inverse of 1 by s into s square plus a square can also be written as L inverse of 1 by s square plus a square, I take it in the numerator, divided by s. My f of s is this. What is this? Is nothing but what? Capital F of s. Now you already know. know that what is L inverse of 1 by square plus A square is nothing but 1 by A into sin AT. We discussed in the last class. Now, therefore, I'll go for which formula? Now, we already written the board. What's the formula now? L inverse of f of S by S. Therefore, here, in this case, what is my f of S is 1 by S square plus A square. I told number of times, you go for this, it's possible to find out inverse of the f of s and also it's possible to integrate after we get f of t. What is L inverse of this function value? This is a standard function, it's nothing but 1 by a into sin a t. Okay? This implies L inverse of, what about that, 1 by a square plus a square divided by s. Is nothing but 0 to t f of t. What is my f of t? 1 by a into sin a t. Yeah, you know that what's the integration of sin is easy to evaluate. What's the integration of this value here? Is nothing but 1 by a. What is integration of sin is minus cos a t. Yes, divided by quotient of a is, t quotient of t is a. What's the limit? 0 to t. In the next step, minus 1 by a square is a constant, keep it outside, apply the upper limit, what's upper limit, cos a t, minus cos a, what is cos a is 1, this can also be written as, I take it to our negative sign inside, 1 minus cos a t. Now this is the easiest way to find out the value, so many methods, but we are going to adopt which method here, L inverse of f of s by s is nothing but 0 to t f of t dt because, in this case, it's possible to bifurcate S in the denominator from the numerator. And also, once you pick it, take it at the numerator, you know what is the inverse of that value of Laplace transform. Therefore, then easily we get, what's the value here? 1 by A square into 1 minus cos A T. Let us move to the second problem. The second problem is S by A square plus A square whole square. Now, I'm not going to use the formula what I discussed in the first problem. I told number of times, if you want to go for this L inverse of f of s by s, you must be bifurcate s in the denominator, but we don't have any s in the denominator. You have s. Therefore, you can't go for that formula. Therefore, what I'm going to do here, I'm going to take L inverse of s by a square plus a square. Are you clear? Now, I want to find out L inverse of S square plus A square whole square. Now, you already know that one of the formula written on the board, F of T by T, what is that? L inverse of S to infinity F of S dS. Now, here, I am going to take this function. What is my F? This is my F of S, okay? This is my F of S. What I am going to do here, using this formula, this implies F of T by T, is nothing but what actually L inverse of S to infinity. I told if you want to go formula, first you verify whether it's possible to integrate this f of s in the range S to infinity. Yeah, it's possible because derivative of s square plus a square is what actually 2s. Therefore, I'm going to use the formula is what f of t by t is nothing but L inverse of S to infinity f of s ds. What is my f of s from this problem here? L inverse of s to infinity. What's the value now? F of s is s by s square plus a square. I'm going to repeat once again. If you want to go for this formula, keep in mind whether it's possible the given f of s is to possible to integrate in the range s to infinity. Then only you have to move, otherwise you don't use this formula. Now I am go for substitution. What's the substitution now? Put u equals s square plus a square. That implies what is du? 2s ds. Now I have to substitute these values where in the integration s to infinity. What is s ds here? 1 by 2 du. Therefore, 1 by 2 is a constant, take it outside of the integration. 1 by, what is s1 plus a square is u. Therefore, whole square is u square. Yeah,
Please try to understand. We are going for substitution method. Sc to ds is what? 1 by 2 into du. What is integration of 1 by 2 is a constant. Better I to take it outside the universe. What is integration of 1 by u square? Take it in the numerator, but we get a to power minus 2 plus 1 divided by minus 2 plus 1. Limit is s to infinity. Okay? In the next step, minus 2 plus 1 is minus. I'll take minus and outside minus half. Here reverse half. What we get actually 1 by, because u power of minus 1. What is my u? Resubstitute the value of u. S square plus a square, because we have a limit based on which value? Yes. Okay. In the next step, half of L inverse of apply the upper limit. What is my upper limit? Infinity. Already I discussed this problem. What is 1 by infinity? What is 1 by infinity? Is 0. Therefore, what we get is 0 minus the lower limit. What's the lower limit? A square plus a square. Yeah. You have negative sign. Minus a to minus you get plus. You already know that one of the standard is that what is L inverse of 1 by a square plus a square? A into 1 by a into sin a t. Yeah, this is the answer of the given function. Now, this is a little bit tough compared to that. You please try to understand s by a square plus a square whole square. Now, I am not going to use the formula L inverse of f of s by s because we can't take s in the denominator. Therefore, what I am going to do here, I am going to take f of t by t. The formula is L inverse of s to infinity f of s ds. I told so many times, you go for this formula whenever it's possible to integrate the given f of s. It's possible from the substitution method. Now, therefore, I'm going to use this formula. Now, I'll take a substitution. U is equal to a square plus a square. Find out the derivative on both sides. Du is nothing but 2s ds because a is a constant is 0. The next is what? Now, I have to substitute s square plus a square is u, we get u square, s into ds is 1 by 2 into du. You know the how to integrate. Now once you integrate, what we get? Minus 1 by u. I take minus sign outside, u is what? S square plus a square. Because still this is a limit based on s. Now apply the upper limit, 1 by infinity is 0, minus the lower limit. Now we get minus a to minus plus, what is L inverse of that standard function is 1 by a to sin a t. This is a way to solve by using which one? Second standard function. Yes, thank you very much for listening my talk. I am going to continue some more problems based on in my next talk, based on the whatever the first standard result, based on that and also second and maybe third.